The following scenes are taken from the story Brunamachata Limone, A Handful of Blackberries, by Ignazio Silone. This scene takes place in the region of Abruzzo, in southern Italy, during the first part of the 20th century. The peasants, Cosimo and Katrina, are brother and sister, and live in an isolated area in the mountains. Katerina only speaks dialect, but Cosimo is able to converse in Italian. In this episode, English is used to represent the dialect. Katerina and Cosimo are sitting outside their house eating a bean stew. They're approached by a policeman.
Katerina, c'è contro di te una denuncia abbastanza grave?
Voi, in the same, you can trouble the police?
Nah, not me, bro. That must be the road sweeper.
Si tratta di Katerina la scopina. Ecco la sua casa.
No, no, parlo con te. Questo pomeriggio non sei stata avvicinata da un poliziero.
Can you say, was that you that spoke to the strangers today?
Non mi hai dato un pezzo di pane?
Give them a bit of bread to me.
That being said, am I getting wrong with that, or? Since when has that been wrong?
Perché l'hai fatto?
Well, he says that there man would be the enemy of us, and he'd do the enemy who escaped. It's not quite that, Rina. You better tell the truth right now, my little girl.
Please, tell me the truth right now.
My enemy? How
can you be my enemy? I never met him before in all my life.
Well, that's Cavalieri, ma'am. Do you say that he's the enemy of us?
Whatever does that mean?
I don't know. What did he look like?
He looked like a man.
A bit of a special to you, uomo?
Non era un uomo di questo contrada.
He said that he'd be the enemy of us, and he'd been announcing. Oh, what was stupid in you, Katerina? What'd you have to go and do that for? Can you have thought before doing it? Oh, I've got to tell you, you didn't think.
Think? Oh, I don't have to think, Paul. That one nothing to think about.
He be somebody's son, don't he?
He'd be hungry. God, I don't have to think.
Stay the crow, I've got to tell you, don't think. Non c'è adesso tutto su, signore.
In altre parole, ti ammetti il fatto.
Oh, no, no. We ain't done nothing wrong, Katerina, have we? We'd be already tired, and we're off to bed. You can put that in that there report. Katerina non ha menti niente. Siamo stanchi e andiamo a letto.
He can't have been a bad guy, that policeman. He just went away and everything seemed to return to normal. Katerina had so many other troubles to think about that she had totally forgot about the incident. However, a few months later, just like before, while eating their soup, who should appear but that policeman?
That black cloud, he'll be back again. I need your help, I do.
Sai, nel frattempo sono cambiate varie cosette.
Who are we talking to? Be it me? Cosimo, you've got to tell me it's got it wrong. Get him to go away.
Did he say that he changes about these ear parts? I don't know, Katerina. Have you seen anything new? I mean, those stones, they still be on.
You are that brain is still be wet. Tell them there may be no changes here.
Che cosa sono cambiate?
Non leggete il giornale.
What's that? Something about the newspapers.
Quelli che erano I nostri nemici sono adesso sono I nostri aliati. Perciò. Quello che alcuni mesi fa sembrare un vostro debito.
Well, they do say that them folks that were our enemies do now be our friends. And you know you got wrong because of that bare bit of bread.
What? What's still going on about that man that was hungry? What was someone's son? The one they wanted to die under?
Katerina, per il suo atto di coraggio, merita un onore.
Katerina? Oh, my God, are we going to knock you up? You see, he gets some things have changed. Well, be like a saint. You've been to learn an act of courage.
Yes, we're not.
An act of courage. He says you're going to get a reward.
Oh, good and bad. Then I'm going to change just like that.
Insomma, donna ignorante, rinunzi alla medaglia?
You're calling your name a woman, what's if you want the medal or not?
Tell Marilyn, do you have a medal?
What I got on that there pilgrimage to Rome in 1900, when I were a girl.
One medal, that'd be quite enough.
Tell him I could show it to him.
But Bonnie Basso, even wearing it to keep him safe from harm.
We've already got one medal in the family war, and that's quite enough.
The policeman went away in discouraged. He related everything to his colleagues, and they all laughed uproariously at those ignorant peasants. However, if they had thought about it just one moment, perhaps those peasants were not so stupid after all, and that it was the authorities who were really the foolish ones.